I hope it's a fucking woman. Oh, I didn't even think about that. Oh, God. Now I don't even want to talk about it. I could be giving this fucking... This is one of my best sexual tricks, man. Anyway, put a little bottle of it. You're making love to your wife, your woman, whoever. Your daughter. I don't care. Sister. Who the fuck knows? You're a sick crowd. Your landlord, your lawyer. Who knows? Could be anybody. You reach over, like in the middle of your sex, when you went, yeah, I fucked long enough. Now it's time to, like, you know, try and write my name on your stomach in my own special sauce. So... Oh, I swear to God, man. You grab this little bottle, you take the top of it off, you smell it. Now, it says, of course, on the bottle, do not inhale. They gotta say that. You know, just like the pillow fucking tags, do not tear off this fucking tag, or you go to pillow jail. What's the fucking crime? What happens? Pillow police come in and beat your fucking ass like you're a pillow molester or something, you know? The fuck is it? You tear, you know, it carries the same sentence. Whatever that crime is, that's what the crime of, you know, do not inhale. Yeah, whatever you fucking say. I bought these to turn them into earrings. The, you know, inhale it, motherfucker. You know? So you smell it, and you're still inside her, of course. And she goes, what's that? Now you're already inside her. She's very vulnerable. She'll trust you. You go, here, smell it. Just smell it like you're fucking Bela Lugosi, man. Go, smell it. And she goes, okay. And you let her smell it, and you take it back, and you smell it again because you want twice the buzz she's fucking getting. And then you put the top back on it and try to get it back to the nightstand. Oh, God, man, you fuck like you're Zor! Fucker from the 15th century! You know. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's the best! It's the best. It is the best fucking high for sex there is, and it's mostly legal. I mean, they'll fuck it up. It'll be against the law someday because it feels too good. You sit there and go, God, man, nothing feels as good. I'm telling you, I've tried it all. I tried nitrous oxide. I'm pretty much the Victor Frankenstein of fucking sex, folks. I'm in the laboratory all the time with my two assistants, of course, Malik and Sabrina. Oh, yeah, I can make the pussy live. I can make the pussy live. Live. Yeah. Fucking crazy madman. I tried nitrous oxide. That's the shit they give you at the dentist office. You know, so I'm sitting there. I'm higher than fucking God, you know. And I'm going, this has got to feel great. How can this not feel great to have a chick suck you while you're this high? Again, I hope it's a woman. I know some guys out there going, yeah, if Charles and I could do that, we could tell them we're studying dentistry in our spare time. Yeah. So anyway. I'm gassed out, man. I'm going, and I'm going, this has got to feel great. This has got to feel great if you're having sex on this, right? So I get a tank. I brought up to the fucking house. Yeah. You know, it's, you know, because you can get it. You know, you can get anything, folks, including sentenced. You can get it all. But I have to bring up the tank. The guy says, now you have to mix this with oxygen. I went, yeah, okay. And don't inhale and don't tear off the tag, right? Yeah, get the fuck out. All right. So I turn it on, man. I just get fucking high, because now it's pure nitrous oxide. I'm going, is it that? You know? The pants go down. The soldier stands at fucking attention, ready to be honored and decorated for service. My dick looks like General fucking Patton. No, it's not true. What actually happened was that, you know, it was rubber dick. You know, it was like I couldn't get hard. I couldn't. There's that. The dick is like, fuck you. I'll get hard if you can walk, genius, all right? The fuck are you doing? Yeah. Yeah, get hard. So that didn't work. It's a great buzz, but, you know, what? Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to take that special member of the family back to his group. There. They cut the air, they say, special members of the family. It's always good to have them right down front. Will you take a picture of me and my mongoloid son? Yeah, yeah. Can I have a copy of this? Oh, God. Yeah, nitrous oxide. Acid, forget about acid. Forget about it. You know, it's great if you're licking pussy. It's great right in the very beginning while you still remember what the pussy is. I went out with Seika for a short time. It was a porn star. The queen of fucking witches, I like to think of her as. Well, you know, I knew what I was getting into. Fuck, I'd seen her films. And I used to get drunk and high, and there'd be magazines laying around. And I go, I'm going to do her. This looks like my kind of woman. This looks like kind of woman that would eat your heart on fucking rye bread for lunch. I eat men and spit them out, you know? So, I mean, it was a natural attraction, like Jessica Hahn. There's some women I'm supposed to meet in life, folks. I don't want to bore you with the conquest. I'm just telling you, now the first time I have to fuck her is like, you know, it's like a wrestling match. It's like a fucking Japanese monster movie. Seika versus Kennison. You know. And I know I'm not going to teach her anything. This is the one time I'm totally humble. I feel like the Karate Kid, you know? Like, oh, yeah. I know I'm not, you know, I'm going to be lucky if I can just appear interesting. And then I get this genius idea. Wait a second, why don't I do acid? And lick her pussy like I'm fucking War Games with a tongue, you know? Every time you fucking create a pattern, you change it. Turn into the tongue ninja. So this sounds like a great fucking idea. So I drop the acid. All right, I'm ready for you now, bitch. Oh, yeah, let's see. You know, so I'm like writing the New Testament on her fucking clit with my tongue. And then all of a sudden, I discover what the pussy really is. It's an opening to another world. It's where life began. Life comes from the universe. It comes, you know. So now you're naked running down the fucking street. Arr, 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 arr. It's 4 in the morning. 4 in the morning, you're naked on all fucking fours in the middle of the highway with the state police going, who is the president? Are you a citizen of this country? Arr, 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 arr. Yeah. So. Do you understand the term? You are under arrest. Oh, God, man. So that's not a good idea. Forget acid and fucking, man. It's just too weird. Oh, well, I know a lot of people go, Sam, do you have any other hobbies? Jesus Christ, is that all you do? Yes! What else is worth doing, man? Women are worth it all. Yeah, Jessica, yeah, ooh. Religious pussy is always so exciting, isn't it? Jimmy Swaggart, is this guy the biggest fucking asshole of the century? There's no way... No way I can respect the guy because he got caught. I would have had so much more respect for him if he hadn't got caught. Because you know, nobody's perfect. Everybody's got a deviant fucking side, especially those fuckers. You know, you can't be on camera every day going, I love God, and I hear from God, and I'm the only one that does, and he told me to tell you to send me all your money. Let me be your special friend. You know, you can't do that fucking shit and not want to, like, you know, squirt on somebody's back and write the scriptures in it. Give me a break. But he pissed me off, man. He pissed me off. This guy should have been on top of it. The year before his big fall, the guy made $135 million. That's what his ministry engrossed, man. That's a lot of fucking money. Shit, you think a guy that would make that kind of money would be sharp enough to go, wait a second, maybe I should be discreet. Maybe people are watching me since I'm on in every fucking country in the world, including China and the fucking Soviet Union. You guys are fucking idiots. Sound like a good idea at the time, probably. We'll be on every country in the world. Yeah, where are you going to run to? So, I would have went to my wife, that fucking bitch she's married to, Francis. I would have went to her and said, honey, I've got to go to New York City. Because preachers are getting together, we're going to pray that we can put prayer back into the schools. You know, and she would have been, that's wonderful, Jimmy. You go. You know, did that fucking move. The guy's in the car now going, all right, okay. I'm going to fuck like I just got out of prison. I would have flown in, went to fucking New York or San Francisco, would have been a good move. Come to San Francisco, get a fucking killer hotel, Fairmont, one of those, Mark Hobson, killer suite. Call up an Oriental escort service, one that gets them right off the boat. They can't even hardly speak English. Get some bitches that couldn't pick you out of a lineup if it was you and two midgets with hats on, man. Be nasty, get it out of your system, fuck them all, do be the nasty, get back on the plane, come back to the wife, go, God spoke to me. He spoke to me while I was in New York, and he said, I've got to go to South America and fuck some of those dumb bitches too. Nah, he wasn't smart to do that. He comes out of his Bible school and goes, hey, wait a second, isn't that a trailer park 3 miles from here? With all the fucking Louisiana pussy you can eat. Oh, Cajun, nasty, What is this guy about? $135 million. He could have dug up Marilyn Monroe and fucked her, man. What the fuck was he thinking? He could have done whatever he wanted. He goes down to a trailer park, gets one of these Louisiana slut whores, and then doesn't want to. Yeah, yeah. Do I look busy at all to you, man? Thanks, dude. Wow. Okay, it's one of our special prayer counselors who wants to talk to you now. Yeah, yeah, good way to, yeah. I'm going to listen to this all the way home. What a great way to introduce your band to me. Take this and do coke on it. All right, so. So anyway, before I was really interrupted by, you know, business management of the year. Swagger, right? He goes down, he argues with this woman. He doesn't want to pay $20 for a blowjob. $20 for a blowjob, that's not an unreasonable price. You that are on dates tonight, guys, you know. What's the ticket price here, right? Around $20, right? 1950, something like that. That's not an unusual or unreasonable price, right? This guy doesn't want to pay $20. I'm going, are you a fucking idiot? He just wants to give her $10. I go, this is going to be the cheapest, dumbest, stupidest motherfucker that has ever lived. He deserves to lose it all. And then I see the picture of her in Penthouse, which we all saw, those fucking nasty black and white pictures, because we didn't want to see that fucking pussy in color, first of all. Like, please, do not fucking colorize these shots, man. Oh, God, I saw her, and then I said, yeah, he was right. $10 was way too fucking much. Shit. God, there had to be license plates, old shoes, pieces of tires. Oh, God, I was skanky looking, man. Fuck him. He deserves what he's fucking getting, that asshole. You know, his wife doesn't let him out of his sight now. Yeah, dumbass, he fucked up. Like all those guys, man, if you're going to fuck, do it. Don't say you're Jesus' fucking representative of the world and like, According to these guys, Jesus would have had 12 models, not 12 disciples. That would have been my move. If I was Jesus, I would have had 12 fucking models. And his first disciple was named Inga. And his second disciple was named Jacqueline. And then he met the sisters. I was like, before he knew it, there were 12. He would look like Robert fucking Palmer of Jerusalem, man. He would look hot. It's Jesus and the 12 model disciples. Oh, yeah. Women that look like Bridget Nielsen. We love Jesus. We love him. And you will, too. I mean, make it a Chanel commercial, man. Yeah. That would have been my move. I did her. It was so exciting. I'm with them. All right? What does that tell you? No, I had to do it because it was. I wanted to see if we were going to explode or not. You know? Sam Kinison and Jessica Hahn, man. We shouldn't even have gotten in bed together. That's too scary. But I love women. What the fuck are you going to do? There's nothing else to do. You have to do everything you can to keep me. I don't want to sound like Dr. Ruth, like I'm a sex therapist here, but I'm a better one than her. Fuck her and her wrinkled, biologically decayed loser ass. I hate Dr. Ruth. I fucking hate her. She doesn't even have a pussy. I'm so sick of her shit, man. America's foremost expert on sex. Yeah. Yeah, she sure is, man. Wow. There's no pussy there. Come on. She's old. There's no hair. There's something that pee comes out of, but you wouldn't recognize it. You would not recognize it. You could take a picture of Dr. Ruth's pussy, put it up on a slide board with four other pictures of pussy, bring a guy in from off the street, go, come here. Come here. Can you tell me what you see here? I go, well, it looks like four pictures of pussy and one picture of a really bad grilled cheese sandwich or something. I don't know that. Oh, God, it's Dr. Ruth!